So RAID 0 uses a technique called striping to improve performance. So if we have one disk, it would have a track 0, track 1, track 2, etc. And the problem is that while the head is positioned to read track 0, it cannot be reading track 1, and also it's very far away from all of these other tracks. So what happens is really we have to serialize accesses to all of the tracks. If we need to read tracks 0, 17, and 27, we will have to decide in what order we access them, but for each of these accesses, we move the head, we read the track, we move on to something else. So we cannot get more performance than just reading one track at a time at the current rotational speed of the disk. What RAID 0 does is it takes two disks and makes them look like this one disk by putting the original track 0 here, track 1 here, track 2 here, track 3 here, and so on. So the idea is that now each of these tracks is called a stripe now, and we're gonna put stripe 0 really here, stripe 1 here, and so on. So track 0 of the first disk gets track 0 from the overall large disk. Track 0 here, however, gets the stripe 0. So instead of calling these tracks, we call them stripes to avoid confusion between what's a track on a physical disk and these things that really are tracks that would belong to a fake disk that we don't really have, because really these two disks are pretending to be this one disk. As far as performance is concerned, we get twice the data throughput if we have two disks. Why? Well, because while the first disk is reading some data, the second could be reading data too, and because controllers and buses today are faster than what the disk can get to, effectively we can transfer twice the amount of data, assuming that both disks are actually transferring the data. You can be unlucky and all the data you want is on the stripes that are placed on this disk, in which case you're gonna get only the data throughput of a single disk. But on average, we tend to get almost twice the throughput of a single disk by splitting the data across two disks like this. As far as latency is concerned, because we have more throughput, we get less queuing delay. Normally, we would be able to handle requests one at a time here. Now we can actually in parallel do two requests. So in the queue, we get faster to the request by basically handling previous requests faster. But what about reliability? Unfortunately, it gets worse than one disk.